Trustee Claude, I've got my hearing aid will be...
Monday.
On Monday, I'm going to get my hearing aid before. And they in a camp. And then... Boy, wait a minute. Yeah, we live in our camp. It was outside, but still connected because it's a city.
Excuse me.
And then everybody had kind of something to cook on. And then we went, we have to have something to eat. In order to eat, you know, they were potatoes on the field, they were cabbage. We did not get shopping. We got cigarettes, tickets. And then we went to the country out on the fields because we knew the man that liked smoking. But we have found out the time when it's the perfect time to go begging because with money they don't want any money or they did. Unless you bring something valuable of your trade. So we went there and then we asked for eggs, the cigarette were gold at that time. But we had to go in the afternoon somehow when the woman isn't home. Because she said, you don't have to smoke, you don't have to blah, 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 you know.
Well, lucky you strike.
You don't have to smoke. So we figured out it is, you know, or she isn't home. Then we can get eggs, you know, and onions and whatever it is, you know. Yeah, but that's during the day. But comes the evening, when the peasant, when the woman is in the stall or how you call it, and it is, you know,
milking the cow.
Mm-hmm. And we knew exactly, you know, in what house to go when.
Wow.
And then, and there was my sister-in-law and I. You know, with a container, you know, standing in line, you know, for me. And of course she said, nobody helps me, nobody helps me, I need help, you know, but everybody's coming and begging, you know, and so. And Katie heard that. And I said to her, what was her name? Sanders, from Sanders. I said, Sanders, Mrs. Sanders, well, if you really need a help, I'd be happy. I'd be happy to come and help you. And she said, you really would? Because, oh, and also what, you cannot get food stamps, your ration, unless you can prove you have a job. And I had no ticket, and I had no job, you know. And then she said, nobody comes, I need help, and nobody comes to help me, but everybody, blah, blah, you know. And I said, oh, I'm willing to come and help you, you know. And then the next day I went there, you know, and I went to the city hall, you know, and I got for my family, I got stamps.
Wow.
And I had my food over there.
Yeah.
And in spite of that, sometimes she was so stingy. She brings load from the field, from the land, a cabbage. Potatoes, they killed a veal, or how you call it?
Calf.
A calf during the night. There was also living one German who was in the German army. Mm. And then probably didn't have anything, but however, and she was alone, you know, and well, whatever. He said that he moved in, and he helped her. She needed somebody desperately because she had a big land and cows and pigs, and so she desperately she needed. And then later on came, I think, a son or a grandson from a relative. So it was two men, and she was there. And then I got there, but I came in the morning, you know.
You commuted back
and forth. Yes, and I started. I was cleaning. I'm not ashamed to say it or anything. That was life at that time, you know. Because if I came that down, she had a war prisoner. She was a war prisoner from Russia. But when the war was over, of course, she went home. Yeah. And that woman had nobody to help her. That's how she got the German in to work. And so where he slept, he had his brother there. And I came in the morning and went home. And each time I had to ask her, can I get a glass or a jar of for milk? I said, can I have milk? And she said, oh, blah, 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 blah. I was working there for nothing. No pay or anything. But asking, you know, she goes, oh, that is a little bit too much. And then she killed a calf during the night. And that would be quite a punishment if anybody finds out about it. I was surprised when I come in the morning and say,
David,
what's the noise, you know? So I wouldn't say anything.
No, this is too late.